Okay, boys, in the last period, we have discussed reactions involving breaking of carbon dioxide oxygen bond in alcohols. In that case, we have already studied reaction with hydrogen halide, reaction with phosphorus halide. Now next year, next reaction from alcohols, dehydration of alcohols. Dehydration of alcohols, that is the reaction in which water molecule is removed from an alcohol to form an alkene is called dehydration of alcohols. And this reaction already we have studied in 11th in topic hydrocarbons in alkenes, preparation methods of alkenes. But this again we will revise here. Here we are studying in chemical reactions of alcohols. So when these alcohols, they are heated with strong dehydrating agent such as concentrated sulfuric acid, phosphoric acid, phosphorus pentoxide, alumina, then alcohol undergo dehydration to form alkene. Now here the ease of dehydration order, it is tertiary alcohol dehydrate more easily than secondary alcohol, it dehydrate more easily than primary alcohol. So this is the ease of dehydration order. Now we are going to discuss in details mechanism of this reaction also. In the mechanism, in the dehydration of alcohols, the intermediate form, it is carbocation. And as you know, the stability of carbocation, tertiary greater than secondary greater than primary. And so therefore, this is the ease of dehydration order. Now we are going to see here dehydration of primary, secondary, tertiary alcohols. So first, so here consider this. I have taken example, that is ethyl alcohol. Now here this ethyl alcohol, this is, we have to heat this ethyl alcohol with concentrated sulfuric acid, and we have to take here 95% concentrated H2SO4 here, and again we have to maintain temperature, that is 443 Kelvin. So when primary alcohol, any primary alcohol, you have to keep in mind the condition, that is you have to take 95% H2SO4 and 443 Kelvin temperature. Then what happens? The ethyl alcohol, it undergo dehydration. Dehydration means what happens? That is this reaction, it is also known as the beta elimination reaction. Beta elimination, because here beta hydrogen atom is removed here. Now this is alpha carbon atom and this is beta carbon atom. So hydrogen from beta carbon is eliminated here. So what happens here? This hydroxyl group and hydrogen, so both these are eliminated in the form of water molecule here, that is H plus here, and this OH minus, that means this carbon acquires negative charge, this carbon acquires positive charge, single bond, it is converted to double bond. And so here this formation of, here that is this alkene takes place. Here, single bond, it is converted to double bond. Here, that is formation of ethene. Plus, byproduct is H2O, water molecule is formed here. So, in this way, any primary alcohol you have to, that is, for example, if you have taken here N-propyl alcohol, so N-propyl alcohol, same condition. That is, N-propyl alcohol is heated with 95% H2SO4 at 443 Kelvin, undergo dehydration to form propene here. Now, in case of secondary alcohol, that is, for example, consider here this, we'll take example, that is, for example, isopropyl alcohol, here. Now, secondary alcohol, the ease of dehydration of secondary alcohol, it is easier than primary. And so, what happens here? That is, the condition gets here decreased. That means, here, we have to take here this 60% H2SO4. It is 60% H2SO4. Again, temperature decreases here. We have to take here, that is 373 Kelvin temperature. So, any secondary alcohol, here, same condition, that is, you have to heat with 60% H2SO4 and 373 Kelvin temperature. Then what happens? Secondary alcohol, again it will undergo dehydration. Here hydroxyl group and beta carbon, beta hydrogen, here there are two beta carbon atoms, but both contain same number of hydrogen atoms. So here Sedgep rule is not applied here. Directly you can remove any one hydrogen here. For example, consider, I will remove here this hydrogen here. That is, I will remove this hydrogen. And so, what happens again? Hydroxyl here and hydrogen, they will remove in the form of water molecule. And so, here this formation of, that is, this again here. Single bond, it is converted to double bond here. And so here formation of this propene plus again here H2 water molecule is formed here. So in this way, any secondary alcohol, if we take here, same condition you have to take here, 60% H2SO4 and 373 Kelvin temperature here. Is it clear? Okay. Now we'll see here in case of tertiary alcohols. So, for tertiary alcohol, that is, consider here this, we'll take tertiary butyl alcohol here. Now, ease of dehydration, it is easily than secondary. So, again what happens here, the condition, it gets decreased here. That is, here, we have to take for tertiary alcohols, 20% H2SO4. We have to take here 20% H2SO4 and again temperature decreases 363 Kelvin for tertiary alcohols. So here also there are 3 beta carbons, they contain same hydrogen, so no Sedgep rule, you can remove any hydrogen. For example, consider here this, I will remove this hydrogen for example here, and so again what happens, that is, this hydroxyl and hydrogen, they are removed in the water molecule, and so here this formation of again here this alkene takes place here, that is formation of single bond, it is converted to double bond. Isobutylene plus again byproduct is H2. So any tertiary alcohol, that is same condition, 20% esters of ore, 363 Kelvin temperature. Here, is it clear? Okay. Now, I will show here another one example. That is, for example, consider here this. I will take this example. We have taken, for example, this secondary butyl alcohol. For example, consider here this. I have taken secondary butyl alcohol. Now this is secondary alcohol. So here condition, what condition we have to apply here? It is, we have to take here 60% H2SO4 again. And temperature that is 373 Kelvin temperature. Now here, what happens? Here there are two beta carbons here, and both does not contain same number of hydrogens. So in such conditions, that is ZZ, that is the name of the scientist, and this he had given a rule here. It is known as the ZZ rule. What ZZ state here? That is, in elimination reaction, hydrogen atom from that adjacent carbon atom is removed, which contains less number of hydrogen atoms here. That means here hydrogen, this carbon contains 3 hydrogen, this carbon contains 2 hydrogen. So the hydrogen will be removed from this carbon according to ZZ rule, and so therefore will obtain the product will be here, that is the product it will be, that is formation of here this alkene takes place here, CH, it is then formation of double bond, and again here it is formation of here this but dash 2 dash EN calcium. So this is according to ZZ rule. Or if we remove this hydrogen here, then what happens? Again here it is, what happens, we will obtain another product here. It is, for example, I will show this product also here. That is, if this hydrogen is removed, then here we will obtain this product here. It is formation of this but 1 ene takes place, formation of but 1 ene here. Again, ZZ here defined by another way here. What here defined by another way here? That is, in elimination reactions, if more than one product is obtained, then the major product is that one which is highly substituted. Highly substituted means what here? That is the product in which there are maximum number of alkyl groups across this double bond here. That will be considered as the highly substituted. That is, this already we have discussed here. For example, here, if we compare but 2ene and but 1ene, here how many alkyl groups are there? That is this one and this one, 2 alkyl groups. While in case of but 1ene, there is only one alkyl group, and so highly substituted it is but 2ene. So but 2ene will be the major product. So this is according to ZZ rule. It is very important here. That is, question is asked here, that is the major product obtained by the dehydration of neopentyl alcohol, for example, or the major product obtained by the dehydration of pentane-2-OL here. So this is very important. That is, according to ZZ rule, we have to find out here the major product. So these reactions, these are the dehydration of alcohols here. That is, these reactions, these are liquid phase dehydration. Because in liquid state, these alcohols dehydration is carried here. So we have to keep in mind the conditions here. Question is asked here, that is, what is the action of, that is, concentrated H2SO4 at different temperature here and at different concentration on propane 1 or propane 2 or 2-methyl propane 2. Long question, it is very important here. It is, what is the action of sulfuric acid at different temperature and concentration on propane 1 or propane 2 or 2-methyl propane 2 or, here it is ethanol. Propane 1 or if we take, it will be dehydration propene. So you have to write correct this concentration and temperature. Is it clear? So this is the liquid phase dehydration we have discussed here. Now there is a mechanism of this reaction in our syllabus. Mechanism, it is very simple here. That is, mechanism of dehydration of alcohol. So question is asked here again, explain the mechanism of dehydration of alcohols. There are 3 steps in the mechanism of dehydration of alcohols, and it is very easy to remember or keep. You have to, that is, keep in mind, that is, there are simple here, that is, the usual steps. First step, protonation. Second step, formation of carbocation. And third step, deprotonation. So we will discuss one by one here. That is, first step here, that is, protonation. First step, protonation. What happens here? That is, for example, I will take example, that is, dehydration of, again here this, we will take here this, ethyl alcohol. So first step, protonation, that is, we have taken here this acid catalyzed sulfuric acid. So what happens here, this proton here, it will add here. What happens, oxygen containing here this lone pair of electrons, and so here, that is, how dehydration takes place, sorry, the protonation, how it takes place, that is, this proton here, it get added on this OH group here, that is, oxygen, its lone pairs, they are involved in the bond formation with proton here, and so here this formation of, that is, this intermediate takes place. Here, formation of this, that is, oxygen, again this hydrogen, and here it is proton addition. Oxygen acquires positive charge. So this is the first step, protonation, addition of proton. Now second step, that is, formation of carbocation. Formation of carbocation. What happens in the second step? Here, that is, this added proton here, with this positive charge. Now what happens in the second step? It is the formation of carbocation here. That is, here water molecule is removed here. That is, removal of, what happens? Water molecule takes place. That means these shared electrons, they are shifted towards oxygen here. And so this carbon acquires positive charge. And so here this, again, that is, formation of, here, this carbon, it acquires positive charge. Carbon, that is formation of carbonium ion. Plus, again, here, formation of, that is H2, water molecule is formed here. That is, water molecule is removed. So, this is the second, formation of carbocation. Now, we have to remove the proton. And so, therefore, third step, that is, again, deprotonation. Third step, that is, again, deprotonation. So, in the deprotonation state, see, this is the third step. We have to remove the proton. So, consider again here this, that is, this carbocation form here. Carbocation. Now, what happens in the deprotonation state? That is, proton is removed here. Proton is removed here. Here, what happens? That is, for example, consider here, this proton is removed here. Proton is removed, so this carbon acquires negative charge, positive, negative, double bond. So here this formation of, that is, again, single bond, it is converted to double bond. And so here this formation of this alkene. Plus, here, byproduct, that is, proton here, removal of proton. So, in this way, there are three steps, mechanisms here. First step, protonation, that is the addition of proton here. Proton is added here. Second step, formation of carbocation, that is, water molecule is removed and carbocation is formed here. Third step, deprotonation. That is, we have to remove the proton. So, here proton is removed and alkene is formed. So, question is asked here, explain the mechanism of dehydration of alcohol for 3 marks here. You have to write correctly these, all these 3 steps here. For each step, 1 mark here. So, this is the mechanism of, that is the dehydration of alcohols here. Now, another there is alternative dehydration method is there. Vapor phase dehydration. In vapor phase dehydration, how the dehydration is carried here? That is, vapors of alcohols, they are heated or they are passed over heated alumina here. Then they undergo dehydration and forms their alkenes here. That means, here, I will show here, only directly I will show here. That is, for example, consider we have taken here ethyl alcohol. So, when the vapors of ethyl alcohol here, or I will show separately. For example, consider here this, that is, here, vapor phase dehydration. How it takes place? That is, for example, consider here this, we have taken primary alcohol, ethyl alcohol. So, ethyl alcohol, what we have to do here? That is, the vapors of ethyl alcohol, they are passed over heated alumina here. Al twice, O thrice. Aluminum oxide or alumina. Again, condition is here, temperature that is here 623 Kelvin temperature. Then what happens? It will undergo dehydration and forms the formation of, that is, alkene takes place. Here, alkene plus H2, water molecule. Any primary alcohol, same, that is, passed over heated alumina at 623 Kelvin. Similarly, in case of secondary alcohol, for example, consider here this secondary alcohol, isopropyl alcohol. Now, the ease of dehydration of secondary alcohol, it is 23 केल्विन. सो एनी सेकेंडरी अल्कोहल इट्स वेपर्स विल पास ओवर हीटेड एलिमेंट 523 केल्विन. इट अंडरगो डिहाइड्रेशन, सेम डिहाइड्रेशन इट इज फॉर्मेशन ऑफ हियर दिस इट इज दिस अल्किन इट इज फॉर्मेशन ऑफ ethene plus I mean here this H2O water molecule is formed here. Similarly tertiary alcohol for example consider here this we have taken tertiary butyl alcohol here. So in case of tertiary butyl alcohol when the vapors of tertiary butyl alcohol they are passed over heated alumina here at about 423 Kelvin temperature. Again it undergo dehydration and forms here that is formation of that is this alkene takes place that is formation of this isobutylene. Isobutylene plus again here this byproduct is H2. So this is vapor phase dehydration. Here only that is dehydrating agent that is alumina temperature different for primary 623 Kelvin, secondary 523, tertiary 423 Kelvin temperature. So this the question also here asked that is what happens when vapors of ethanol are passed over heated alumina here or what happens when vapors of propane 2-OL is passed over heated alumina. Then you have to write the dehydration reaction correct. You have to write the temperature. So in this case here we have seen the dehydration of alcohol reaction different concentration different temperature is of dehydration its mechanism and again vapor phase dehydration reaction. Is it clear? Okay.